1?
It's 11 a.m. and I'm at the XSplit booth because I'm going to be doing a panel right now, streamed live on XSplit about finding your community on Twitch. I didn't film any of the traveling to PAX because it was 12 hours overnight and it was hellish for me. So I didn't think that you would want to see it. But this panel is going to be really fun. We're going to be talking about finding your community. I have a couple other panelists and we're gonna do some talking.
I got an email from someone right before I came here that said, because of you being so open with mental health and with trans issues and with LGBTQ stuff, I have learned so much from your chat. And they said, I was never a discriminating person, but I just wasn't educated.
Yeah.
There's a lot of internal prejudice and bias that you don't realize you have until you encounter a situation.
100%. Yeah, and this cis woman contacted me and was like, I was not against trans people. I was pro-gay and all that good stuff. I was like, perfect. But she's like, but since speaking to the trans girls in chat, I feel like I have a way better understanding of what they go through and how I can be an ally to them. Mm. And she was like, it's the first time I've thought that I could be an ally.
Yeah.
And I'm like, that's amazing. And she's like, I would, in a social situation, if necessary, I would protect these girls with my life. And I'm like, that's great. And just having the conversation of that coming up in chat, if that's even educated one person who felt the need to reach out, it means that I've probably helped educate other people, even on a smaller scale, but who didn't feel the need to put it into an email. And that's incredible. So using your voice as a streamer and with the audience that we are fortunate enough to have, we definitely, and it's not just us, streamers and YouTubers and people with an audience should be doing this more. Later in the day, I'll admit, I found Jordan.
Hey.
And we just left Tabletop Free Play.
Hello.
How you doing?
And we're seeing Desert Bus fans, which is pretty cool. We're heading over to the SteelSeries booth right now because I need to go pick something up. The rest of the day is busy. We've got the Automata panel. We've got For Honor for the Watch. We've got my Jackbox panel. And there was one other one in there somewhere, and I don't remember what it was. I'll figure it out. At some point.
PAX is busy, yo.
PAX is very busy. Tomorrow's gonna be exciting as well, because we have the chat meetup in the morning. I got put onto the PAX Mania PAX Rumble, which is going to be ridiculous.
Now, how much wrestling do you know?
Zero wrestling. I've never played the game. Making our way through the show floor, this is the busiest PAX I've ever gone to. The show floor is huge, and it's all on one level. So, it's a little busy, but we'll get through it.
Surprisingly spacious, though.
It's huge. This PAX is huge.
Like, Kanye loves Kanye.
Jordan's been talking about Kanye West for like 5 minutes. I can't remember what I filmed last, but we are at the Automata panel now. Good turnout this year.
I miss the old Kanye.
I miss the old Kanye. No, we just snuck in early. Will and Van are up on stage, and they're going to be talking about Automata for a while, which is very exciting. And then from there, I think we're going to the PAX Arena for the Watch. And then we still haven't figured out what that panel in the middle is. I'm not sure. But I ate food, which was very exciting. And I picked up some pins, so now I'm pretty full. It's only day one, but I'm pretty full on the pins. So I'm pretty happy with it.
Straight from the go, Kanye.
That could be a quick look to the side and a quick death for Dave. That could be the anger coming to play. We let the anger cloud this
year. Was Gabe Easy Pickens on the other side?
Sorry, who's he again?
Pero Diablo! Oh my god, okay, we're just gonna let this one. This is too much. I'm too hot down here. We're gonna send it back over to the casters, my goodness.
I'm here with Nika, and
Hi.
We're getting ready for the Jackbox panel.
That's what we're doing.
There's also a Chris and a Mikey and a Jeff over there.
But they're not on camera right now.
Not right now.
Not important.
But the room is filling.
It's huge.
There's a lot of humans here. Now, here's the thing. The last time I did this show, it was on the main stage, but you couldn't see anybody. So now I can see everybody, and it's a little
intimidating?
Stressful?
Only look at the people that you know.
Okay, I know that one, and I know that one, and I know that one.
If they're laughing, you're good.
And I know them.
Yeah, like, that's it. Let's just pay attention.
We're fine. This is going to be a great panel.
All right, welcome everybody to Jackbox at PAX Box. We're going to play some fun party games. We're going to start with Quiplash, and then we're going to move on to TKO. But first, let me introduce our awesome panel here. We've got the one and only Chris Straub.
I have no notoriety. Yeah, it's all over there.
And the dapper Mikey Newman.
Ooh, dapper. I have zero credibility up here. I'm trying to figure out how the hell I ended up on this thing, honest, among all these people.
Jeff Callis, everybody.
Woo! I'm the corporate guy.
You're in the suit.
The lovely Kate Stark. Miss Nika Harper. And everybody knows Jerry Holkins.
Next on the list, the rest of the country claims they cheat, but the real reason the Patriots keep winning is blank.
Thank God I did not get this.
And vote.
That's just pandering. Applause line in the text.
Do not put 2 exclamation points. Come on. It's not fine.
I don't know much about football. I know Tom Brady's
ass. That's a lot of points, Kate.
It is 10:30. I have been in this convention center for 13 hours. I just finished my Jackbox panel, and it went fine. People had a good time. I did horribly, but that's fine. That's to be expected with me. I'm going to leave this convention center. It's snowing like a motherfucker outside, but that's been happening all day long. And I'm going to go to my hotel, and I'm going to fucking sleep, because tomorrow is Chat Meetup and the PAX Rumble, and meetings all in between both of those things. So I will see you for PAX Day 2 tomorrow. Good morning from PAX Day 2. I wasn't able to vlog much yesterday because I had so much going on. I don't think I sat until about 10 or 9 when I was on my Jackbox panel. I had a really good time yesterday. Today is gonna be more fun, potentially, than yesterday because I have my chat meetup in like 45 minutes. I'm gonna run to Dunkin' Donuts and try to get a bunch of donuts for everybody right now. I hope that I can find one nearby because it is negative 12 and snowing outside. And then I get to go see my friend's panel at 12:30. And then at 4, I get to be on the PAX Rumble representing Team Canada, which is this whole ridiculous wrestling video game situation. It's very funny. Look outside, by the way. I look into a little courtyard and it is just covered in snow. It was a blizzard yesterday. There were jokes being made that PAX East turned into BlizzCon. I didn't say they were good jokes, but apparently the Dunkin' Donuts is in a hospital. So now I'm in a hospital looking for donuts. I'm so confused.
Just chilling in the Westin lobby totally casually with Elle and Nick.
Yeah, just hanging out.
Just the three of us.
Just us.
Definitely not all of these people.
Not all of them.
I don't know who they are. They just showed up and started eating all my donuts.
And they were really good.
God, they're so rude.
They're good donuts, Brent.
They're good donuts, Brent. I 100% don't give a shit, Tom.
100% don't give a shit.
For real, though, it's the Chatloaf meetup, and all these lovely people showed up to hang out, and I'm only this much overwhelmed by their kindness and generosity. I'm friends with that person.
Why?
I choose to hang out with
Why?
You. No. Just finished up with the chat meetup and I'm on my way to a panel. I'm with some friends on the escalator and we are trying to find the Condor Theater. The meetup was amazing. There were so many people there and everyone was so lovely and we had donuts and we chatted and we told stories and I had a really, really, really good time. And now I am running to a panel. Hopefully I can find it. I managed to find the panel I was looking for. It is the Empires of Eve panel. My friend Andy is doing it. And so I'm going to be in this for the next hour, I think. And then I'm going to try to prep for the PAX Rumble. They sent us a list of controls of how to play the game because no one ever knows how to play the game. So I'm going to try to do some research so I actually win. But I doubt that's going to happen. Fingers crossed.
I am here ready for the PAXmania, not the PAX Rumble, that's a different one. For the Lee Who Feels PAXmania 3, which is going to be very exciting, representing Team Canada. The theater is loading in just now, and I just got the show order and found out what I'm doing, so this is going to be great. And I don't know how to play the game, so that's also going to be very good. But I figure I'm going to apologize a ton, because I'm Canadian, and just be incredibly polite, and that'll be also maybe good.
We want to thank you very much for joining us. We are Saturday afternoon from 4 to 6 p.m., which is the most time that we've ever been given. We keep failing upwards, and we appreciate you coming out and seeing the show. Mostly owner of League of Keels, Johnny Casanova, John Drake is here.
In traditional PAX fashion, this mic is already open. It's already, cracked.
Well, John?
Yeah, exactly. For once, that joke actually works. Good job, everybody. You did a joke that works. And the power of your hatred made the microphone function. Damn it, cut out in the middle of that.
We'll be hearing from John Drake sporadically throughout the show.
You can't stop me.
That's on purpose. That has to be on purpose.
All right, so as mentioned before the match started, there are several ways to be eliminated. You can be thrown over the top rope. You can be pinned.
We've got Kate Stark on Team Canada.
Who?
Shit.
Who's that? Never heard of her.
Hi, I'm just really happy to be here and represent Prime Minister Daddy Trudeau.
Great. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me. I'm really excited.
Yeah, that's awesome. Great.
Sweet. Yeah.
I don't know. Great, I don't know what's happening.
Solid
right now.
Who are all these people you're talking about? Are they in a real country?
A real country. I'm hearing from Dan. He's a little bit hungry right now, so we're gonna pause and
Oh my God!
That was the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
That could have gone real bad, guys.
It is much later now. It is 9 o'clock. Movies with Mikey starts in 30 minutes. Woo! I have managed to eat a food, sort of. I need to go pick up my coat from the Twitch Prime, lounge, which is pretty cool. They've got free food and music and quiet and purple. It's very common, very lovely. But they have free coat check in there, and I need to get it because I and enforcers do not know when it closes. Super excited for the panel. Here with the Jeech.
Hey, what up?
And then probably go back to the hotel because it's PAX Day 2 and I'm very, very tired. I need a night of sleep. That is it for PAX Day 2. Today was really exciting. The chat meetup was amazing and the PAXmania was also very, very fun. I did lose exceptionally quickly and terribly, but I got to be a fun, very polite Canadian, so I had fun with that. Tomorrow is the last day of PAX and I don't have as much going on tomorrow. I do have a couple meetings and Acquisitions Incorporated and the final round of the Omegathon. Okay, saying it all out loud makes me realize I actually do have a lot of stuff going on tomorrow, but it seems like a more chill day because I don't have any panels. So I'm very excited for tomorrow as well. I'm gonna go sleep because I am so, so tired. And I'll see you all tomorrow. Welcome to PAX Day 3, aka PAX Day the Last. My throat is a little bit sore. I can tell that I'm feeling a little bit raspy, but I'm not sick. I've just been talking a lot. I also realize it looks like nighttime in here. It's not, it's noon, but I'm just getting going for the day. I have a couple meetings on the show floor today, which I'm really excited about. This morning has been a bit of a mess though, because there's a giant blizzard warning coming in, and not blizzard Overwatch blizzard like snow, a snowstorm blizzard warning coming in for tomorrow, Tuesday, which is when I'm supposed to fly home. So I've been on the phone and on the internet with Air Canada today, trying to switch my flights to tomorrow instead of Tuesday, because I really don't want to get stuck in Boston. So it looks like it's going to be a bit of a mess. They said anywhere between 6 and 16 inches of snow. So I got my flight sorted out. I go home tomorrow instead of Tuesday, which sucks, but that's fine. I'd rather be home than stuck in Boston. But for now, we're going to catch a lift, and we're going to go to the convention center and have our meetings. It's going to be a really good last day. I am, however, dressed in my funeral attire because we are eulogizing PAX East 2017.
Kate, how's your PAX been?
PAX has been incredibly busy and tiring, but really, really good. I've had a really good time.
I'm glad. What was your favorite part?
Probably my chat meetup on Saturday morning. That was really fun. I also had a good time at the PAX Mania and the Jackbox panel.
That's awesome. I'm glad you're having a good PAX. How do you feel about Boston?
Boston is, I have not seen any of it. It's very snowy and very cold. And I have avoided going outside, honestly.
That's fair. Me too. Me too. Well, thanks for hanging out with me.
Yeah, no problem.
Answering some questions.
No problem. Thanks for having me.
Yeah. Hope you guys have a great rest of your PAX and enjoy what's going on. And maybe you'll see Kate. Kate, you can be found on...
It's twitch.com/Kate.
Website.gov. All right. We'll see you next episode.
We're at the final round of the Omegathon. I'm here with TQ and Gavin and Brittany and Alyssa.
Are you in B-roll?
Jeff. And Van and Dave and Mike and Jerry. And we got to know what's going on. We're not really sure, obviously, what the game is because the final round of the Omegathon is always a big surprise. Any guesses? We did this last time.
I don't know. All I know about East is that Gab says that it's normally a dual team. So there are always two people on each team.
Interesting.
And it's a little bit shorter. So they take out all the chairs in here so people stand to fill the theater more.
That's smart.
Yeah.
Apparently, yeah, there's VIP seating here, which is we're very lucky to be in. And then there's all this standing room. And so they squeeze a ton of people in. And in any of the other theaters, you may have seen the South Theater. It looks huge, but you can get more people in here because it's a ballroom.
Pro tip, if you want to be in VIP, data designer. Data designer.
I don't.
Data designer.
I'm not going to do that.
Data designer. You can have mine.
Okay. Okay. We'll trade. Okay. You can have no one.
Okay.
And I'll have. Yeah.
No, wait, I just want to share.
I know. We're going to talk about this now.
How are we feeling tonight? Yes, a bloodthirsty crowd. That's what we like at the final round of the Omegathon.
So, are there guesses? What do you think the final round is going to be?
Rollercoaster Tycoon!
No. I'm disgusted by that. No.
What?
That? No.
Pervert. No.
No, you're perverts.
That's disgusting.
No. All of us, listen.
They're all wrong.
No. That's easily the worst.
I've never heard guesses that bad.
Listen, you provide the first part of the clue, I will provide the second part of the clue.
I don't want to give too much away, but I will tell you that these Omeganauts are going to have to keep talking.
Is the star, like, hollow in the center?
Yes.
Okay, so do copyright symbol, mirrored K,
mirrored
the
K.
R, and the star.
R, star, yeah.
Yes!
All right, what else you got?
I have a hold button.
A button?
Yeah, I have the hold button.
We will see you at PAX West.
Back in my hotel room after the last day of PAX, and that was a wonderful show. Tonight was amazing. Myself and a bunch of friends went to this Italian restaurant and had probably the best meal I have ever had in my life, and then went to a place called Mike's Place or Mike's Palace, I'm not sure, for ginormous cannolis. And it was just such a nice way to like wind down after PAX with a bunch of good friends, eating a bunch of amazing food. And then we went back to the lobby of the West End and played some games for a while. And I was honestly so wrapped up in the games I didn't even think to film. I fly out tomorrow at 5 p.m., I think. And then I think I get home around 10 p.m. It's a little bit longer than that because of the 3-hour time difference. So I think it's like an 8-hour trip, which isn't the worst. And I get to miss the snowstorm, and I won't be getting stuck in Boston, which sounds amazing. So
I'm kind of bummed I'm losing an extra day in Boston to like do stuff outside of PAX, but I'd rather lose a day than have to stay an extra three. PAX is so, so good, and I'm so, so glad I gotta come to this one. I'm probably gonna vlog a little bit tomorrow, so stay tuned for that, and I will see all of you tomorrow. I'm gonna sleep so well tonight. I'm so excited. It is Monday morning, and that is it for Boston. I spent part of the afternoon out at a couple shops I wanted to visit. I got a few things, packed up my suitcase, which is back here, did a sweep of the hotel room, and now I'm on my way to the airport, which I assume is going to be crazy busy because everyone has rebooked their flights from tomorrow to today, trying to get away from the snowstorm. So I have probably 9 hours of flying ahead of me, 10 perhaps. All right, let's get to the airport. I've been in this airport for 6 hours. I have had 2 delayed flights. I might be flying to Toronto right now, and then no way of getting home from Toronto, so I might be stuck in Toronto for a night and then hopefully getting a comped hotel so I can fly back to Victoria. I'll tell you everything when I get to Toronto, if I get to Toronto. Okay, it's been 6 hours. I'm actually boarding a flight. Okay, on board. Emergency exit row, lots of leg room. This might work. But I have contacted Air Canada and they said they do not have hotel rooms. I really don't want to sleep in an airport overnight. I'd really like to avoid that. It's better than sleeping in this airport until Wednesday, but we'll see what happens. I look tired, very tired, but I made it to Toronto. It is 10 past 12. I'm going to try to rebook my flight to get home tomorrow. I don't know when that's happening. And then I need to find a hotel, and then I need to get food, because I have done none of these things. I ate 3 mini bags of pretzels on the plane, and I got a little drunk, then I watched Star Trek. So a pretty good flight, but now I need to figure out where the heck I'm going. That was the fastest ever line at security, but now I need to find my bag, and I don't even know if it made it here because there was a confusion with my bag at Logan International Airport, so there's the chance they've lost it. Well, I got a connecting flight for Victoria tomorrow at like 2 p.m. It's about 1 a.m. Toronto time. I still need to get a hotel and I need to get food. They gave me a meal voucher and they can't get me a hotel, but he said to wait over here and then maybe he could help. So I'm gonna wait here and see what happens. It is much later, and as you can see, I am in a bed. I'm in a hotel room. It is 2:45 in the morning. I managed to get a hotel room and a car service to take me to the hotel, but the only hotel that was available was about a half hour drive from the airport. Being half an hour away from the airport, there is no food open. This hotel does not have room service. There are no restaurants around here. There is no pizza delivery around here. I do, however, have a big old bag of McDonald's, which I don't normally eat, but we are in a desperate situation here. So I'm gonna eat all of this McDonald's and take a nice hot shower because I have been in airports for 12 hours now. And I'm gonna watch some TV and then go the F to bed. And wake up and go right back to the airport and have a 6 hour flight home, hopefully. They wanted to put me on a flight in 5 hours, and I said, no, I'm sorry, I really need some sleep. So I have a flight in about 11 hours, but I need to be there 2 hours early, and apparently it's supposed to snow heavily overnight here in Toronto. So I might get stuck in Toronto. I don't know if I'm ever getting home, but I hope I will. All right, I'm gonna eat this McDonald's and I'll see you tomorrow. It's the morning after travel day from hell. I don't look great, but it's because I slept in this hotel room last night and the heat broke in the middle of the night, so I had to get up and get fully dressed just so I could sleep okay. It was honestly pretty tragic. A car is here to take me to the airport. I should have been home 12 hours ago, and I have another 6 or 7 hours of travel ahead of me, but I was given a meal voucher so I can go to the airport and try to get breakfast. The screen is all blurry, but my bags are checked and I get to go through security and I gotta go find food and maybe margaritas, and I'm very excited about both of those things. The quest for food begins. Made it through security, accidentally left a bottle of, a can of pop in my bag, and security didn't like that so much, but now I'm through the gates and it's all fine, but I was given meal vouchers, so I'm looking for food. I require it before this flight, and I have an hour and a half before my flight, so I can actually sit down and, like, have a meal.
Looking outside, of course, we will be de-icing across the way at the de-ice facility. Our dispatchers have been saying the average time on the ground today for de-icing and spraying is been about 35 minutes, so it's going to be a fairly lengthy taxi time on the ground today. Once we're airborne, we're flying over the northern United States. Reportedly, a fairly smooth ride on the way to Vancouver.
Made it to Vancouver. I look a mess, but I managed to sleep and eat on the plane, so that's really good. I am 20 minutes away from my last flight to Victoria. Hopefully it hasn't boarded and I can get another thing of food and make it safely onto this flight.
You're traveling with a passport? Have the passport open
to the phone page. I'm home. We finally made it back to Victoria and I'm home. And I'm gonna go meet my parents and pick up my bag and I'm gonna go home.